You gonna make a decision? What are you gonna do? You gonna hang out with me or you gonna go out there?
So indecisive.
She's like, maybe I wanna stay.
I'm gonna go get her a treat real quick. BRB.
How much you're shedding. You're shedding so much.
She is blowing her coat.
I gotta film.
Oh, you got me. You got me so good.
The shedding. It begins.
Welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to have you guys here today. I am feeling so much better. I had a cold last week and it just really knocked me off my feet. I was super lazy, super unmotivated, as you probably saw from the past 2 weeks of videos. So I'm just, we just take our health for granted so much. I'm so happy to be feeling better, to be feeling healthy, to have my voice back, to actually be able to speak and produce content. So today we're going to talk about how to organize your creative projects. And every single tool that I provide you with today is absolutely free. And I know that there are a lot of amazing project management tools out there like Asana and Trello, and I have used trial versions of those, but as a solopreneur and someone who is running her business on her own, I don't have a giant team that I need to delegate tasks to, at least not yet. So I wanted to find a system that worked for me, and I know there are many of you out there who are aspiring authors, you're writers, you are aspiring creative entrepreneurs, and so I figured this would be a really good way to share my project management method with you. But first, seeing as it is Cyber Monday when this video is going live, I wanted to make sure that you are aware of all of the amazing Black Friday, Cyber Monday deals that I have got going on, because there are a lot of them. The first is my ebook sale on KDP. That actually ends today, so you can get all 7 of my books in ebook format for just $15. So that is 7 books for the price of what 1 paperback book normally costs. And the great thing about this Kindle price promotion, this Black Friday Cyber Monday deal, is that you don't need a Kindle to participate. So all you have to do is log on to Amazon.com via your smartphone, smart device, tablet, iPad, iPhone, whatever it is, and type in author Kristen Martin, and all of my books will pop up, and you can just download them straight to your phone, to your smart device, in ebook format, and start reading. The second Black Friday deal is to save on Own Your Thrive tickets. And just in case you don't know, Own Your Thrive is a women's conference that I will be hosting next year, May 16th to 17th, in The Woodlands, Texas, and it is for the aspiring creative female entrepreneur. You can save 20% off your ticket with the code ownit111 if you get it before December 31st, 2019. But if you get your ticket by today, 11:59 p.m. Central Standard Time, then you will get access to an exclusive live planning workshop for 2020 with me. To learn more about Own Your Thrive and get your ticket today, you can go to thatsmarthustle.com/ownyourthrive. You can also find that link in the description box below. The third Black Friday deal is something that I never do. I'm opening myself up for one-on-one calls next year in January and February of 2020. So you can get a 40-minute one-on-one call with me for just $111. And this call can honestly be anything that you want it to be. If you just want to chat about life, your vision, goals, very specific questions about writing your book or publishing your book or starting a creative business, this call is for you. It is your time, and I want you to get the most out of it as possible. Make sure to check out the description box below for the link to go ahead and sign up for a one-on-one call with yours truly. Just so you know, that link does expire tonight at 11:59 p.m. Central Standard Time, so it truly is a Black Friday, Cyber Monday only deal. Again, one-on-one calls are something that I do not make myself available for, so this is a super rare opportunity to sit down with me one-on-one and get all of your questions answered. I cannot wait to chat with you. And the last Black Friday, Cyber Monday deal ties in perfectly with today's video on how to organize your creative projects, because it is a brand new worksheet bundle called Project Slay, and I am offering it for only $33. Yes, you heard that correctly. A while back on Instagram, I asked you what you struggled with the most when it comes to creative projects. From starting the project to seeing it through to the very end to all that stuff in the middle and not really knowing what to do next and what the timeline should look like and getting off track or getting a new idea like shiny idea syndrome and going off on a tangent and working on that one instead. That is why I created Project Slay, because I realized that with all of my projects, it is the exact same format. No matter what kind of project it is, this can even work for professional projects. When I was working in the corporate world, I still used this exact same methodology. So Project Slay is a 30-page worksheet bundle that I am offering for $33 for Black Friday and Cyber Monday. And just so you guys know, there is a lot of demand for this. So even if you are watching this video after Black Friday and Cyber Monday have passed, make sure to check out the link in the description box below, because you might still be able to get it for $33. But this worksheet bundle is the only blueprint that you will ever need for any project that you set out to achieve ever again. Okay, so without further ado, let's go ahead and get on into today's video, how to organize your creative projects. My process for organizing my creative projects consists of only 3 steps. So this video probably isn't going to be that long. But if you guys did watch my video on how to organize your projects in notebooks, if you watched that video, I'm still using that methodology, except I have switched things up just a little bit. So in that video, I believe I had like 7, 8, 9 notebooks. I kind of pared that down, so all of those notebooks are full. You'll probably notice these are a little bit different, but now I only have 4 notebooks. So the first notebook that I have is for book ideas, whether these are fiction book ideas or nonfiction book ideas, like for personal development. All of those ideas go into this notebook. Really what I use my notebooks for is mostly for brainstorming or brain dumping, if you will. And then I tend to take my planning of that book offline, like either on a computer or on a separate sheet of paper. Sometimes I will do it in the notebook itself, but a lot of these notebooks, just FYI, are mostly for brain dumping and for ideas. The second notebook I have, which is really hard to see, it's like this really pretty light pink color. This is my Own Your Thrive notebook. It totally matches the vibe and the aesthetic of the Own Your Thrive event. So this is more for, I guess you could say, events or conferences, workshops, things like that. But honestly, since Own Your Thrive is so big, it has its own notebook. My third notebook is sitting right in front of me. This is actually my content notebook. I've gotten a lot of use out of this one. You can see some things are tabbed here. This is what I use now when I just want to jot down ideas for YouTube videos, for podcast episodes, maybe if I think of something I want to say on Instagram, like in one of my stories or an Instagram post. So really this is any kind of content that I use in terms of social media, so YouTube, podcasting, and Instagram. And the last notebook that I have is for my courses and programs and things like the Project Slay worksheet bundle. Anytime I'm going to create something new or launch a new product or service, or if I'm going to add content or video tutorials or, you know, workbooks to any of my courses and programs, all of that goes into this notebook. So when I talk about doing brain dumps, what I tend to do in each one of these notebooks, how I use it, is not only will I put the project plan sometimes in these notebooks, I also like to do a brain dump. So if I come up with a new product, let's say, that would go in this notebook. And I would just brain dump all of the ideas that I have for that product, any questions that I have, the resources that I have at my disposal, or maybe if there's someone out there I need to talk to see how to, I don't know, get that product or service or whatever it is up and running. In a nutshell, it's basically writing down all of the things that I know and the things that I don't know when it comes to a new project. So of course, there are project management apps like Asana and Trello, and while I can't really speak to those because I've only done free trials and I also don't have a team of people where I am delegating tasks or really need to speak to anyone regularly, I just use something that came on my Mac desktop, which are stickies. I literally use sticky notes. So I'm gonna show you on my desktop how I use these.
So if you open your Finder window and you go into your applications folder and just type in stickies, you will see them right here. So you can go ahead and just double click on that. You could see you can add new notes here. So I've given you some examples so you can kind of see how I do this, but I'll take my ideas and all of my projects from my notebooks and I will organize them like this. So you can actually move the sticky up and down this way. So that way when I log onto my computer every single morning, this is the first thing that I see. So it gives me a great overview of what is going on with my current projects. So you'll see here I have project one, I have the launch date, I have Own Your Thrive, any kind of program additions, the Jaded Spring release, and then project number five. So this is just an example of what my project layout looks like in the sticky notes. And you'll see as you move this down here, you can have task one and your deadline, task two and your deadline, so on and so forth. I use this little check mark to indicate when I have completed the tasks for that project. Stickies are a great project management tool to use, not to mention it is free. So I find that it is somewhat similar to Asana and Trello in the fact that, you know, it's just right in front of your face all the time. I really like this because it's right on my desktop and I can organize it however I like, which is also really nice for me. Now, this third step is definitely optional, but I love using Google Calendar. I love it because, well, I'm not wearing my Apple Watch right now, but Google Calendar syncs to your Apple Watch. So that way when a deadline is approaching, I have it popping up on my Apple Watch and also on my phone and on my computer. It's like a multiple reminder system. It's everywhere, which is amazing. And just recently I did invest in a Google Home. So it's really nice because in the morning I can say, good morning, Google. And it lists off my events or my appointments for the day. So that way I can see or hear these tasks first thing in the morning. And that gets my mind going into project mode. So those are really my three steps. I have my notebooks for all of my ideas and brain dumping and figuring out what I know about a project, what I don't know about a project. I will make a very rough sketch of a project plan in that notebook by using the Project Slay worksheet bundle. And then I actually use my sticky notes on my desktop to organize everything so that way it is in a really easy to view format and it's something I see every day because I am on my computer working Monday through Friday, sometimes even on Saturdays. And then I sync everything to Google Calendar because then the reminders pop up on my phone, on my Apple Watch, on my computer, on my Google Home. So that way I just always have my projects at the forefront of my mind. And that helps me maintain momentum to see the projects through to the very end. Now this may seem like a little bit of work and it is, but like with any project, it's the preparation and the setup that is going to take the longest. And the only way to get better at preparation and setup for your projects is to do it more often, to get familiar with it, to have your own organizational process for creative projects. Most people get stuck with their projects because they only complete the steps that they know, and then once the steps that they know are completed, they don't know what to do next. So they lose that momentum. That's why having a project plan in place first, so you can figure out everything that you need to know. And just to be honest, there are going to be things that pop up along the way that you're like, oh, I guess I need to research that. I didn't know about that. Or, you know, something else pops up and you're like, oh, like maybe I need to actually move this step over here. The point is to not only have a plan for the things that you do know you need to do and that you probably know how to do, but to also have a rough plan in place, some kind of an idea for how you're going to conquer the things that you don't know how to do. Plan for what you do know, plan for what you don't know, and you will have a project plan that will see you through to the very end. So that is it for today's video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up to support my channel. And don't forget to click that subscribe button as well as that little bell that will send you email notifications to your inbox whenever I upload new videos. And just a reminder, don't forget to check out the description box below for all of these amazing Black Friday and Cyber Monday deals. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you more than you know, and I will see you in next week's video. Bye.